Hello guys, so I hope you understood up to the last video where I have completed about all those exoskeleton and endoskeleton. Still, if any doubt is there, then ask in the comment box so that I will clarify that one about those exoskeleton and endoskeleton combinedly integument. So today in this video we are going to understand about this molting process. Okay, or this ecdysis process, and later on we will understand what is sclerotization and melanization. Okay, so without wasting time, let's start. What is molting? Molting, or otherwise called as what? Ecdysis. Okay, now you see the insect cuticle is very hard and form unstretchable exoskeleton. What does it mean? The insect cuticle is very hard. Why they are very hard? Because they have this exoskeleton, the integument, which is having hard rigid cement layer. Again, exocuticle will be there. In exocuticle, sclerotization will be there, producing sclerotin protein. That's why the insect cuticle is very hard. But the insect has to increase its size, yes or no? Suppose the insect is in egg stage, the eggs will become larva. Okay, the larva must increase its size. Okay, the size will be increased, then they will pupate. Okay, then they will become adult. Okay, then they will become adult. So this increase in size, okay, how they will increase? Suppose the insect cuticle is very hard and the in size must be increased, so how they will remove the cuticle? How they will remove its integument? The old integument must be shed so that new one will be formed, then the insect will grow its size. This process is called as what? Molting or ecdysis. You see here, before the old cuticle is shed, new one has to be formed underneath it. Before the old will be removed, the new one has to be formed, so that when the old one will be removed, new one is already there on the insect. Okay. The mechanism of shedding of old cuticle and formation of new cuticle is known as what? Molting or ecdysis. Okay, the mechanism of shedding of old cuticle and formation of new cuticle is known as what? Molting or ecdysis. Some term you have to remember here. Then come to exuviae. What is exuviae? The old cuticle which is shed off in the process of molting is known as what? Exuviae. That means what? You see, suppose this one is the insect. While undergoing molting or ecdysis, the old one has removed. Okay, this old cuticle will be known as what? Exuviae. I hope you understand this one. Okay, this one is what? Exuviae. Okay, that means what? Before formation of this new cuticle, after formation of this new cuticle, the old cuticle will be removed. This is known as what? Exuviae. Molting occurs many times in an insect during the immature stages before attaining the adulthood. That means what? In general, insect undergo molting in their immature stages. Okay, that means what? In their, broadly you can tell, in their larval stages. Okay, in their immature stages only they will undergo molting, but some exceptions are there. In heterozygota, every stages, then in case of this mayfly, ephemeroptera, okay, they have different kind of mechanism. So these are things are different. Some exceptions are there, I will tell you later. But then come to this stadium and this instar. Okay, what is stadium? The interval between two subsequent molting is known as what stadium? The interval, the time interval, time unit in between two molting is known as what stadium? The body form between egg stage and the first molting, okay, between egg stage and first molting and two subsequent molting is called as what? Instar. So for easy understanding of all those things, okay, first I will show you in graphical way by drawing all those things, then I will show you some two pictures in which you can easily understand what is stadium and what is instar and what are the in-depth knowledge of that. Okay, so start that one. Suppose this is the egg stage, then what will come? One larva will come, then they will undergo first molting, then their size will increase, then they will undergo second molting, then their size will increase, it is increasing, huh? Then they will undergo another molting, again their size will increase, okay, up to 5 will grow, then again they will undergo molting, a larger larva will be created, okay, then what will happen? They will become a pupa, okay, then they will become winged adults. Then they will become the adult. So you see here you have to understand three terms. One is metamorphosis, another one is your stadium. Okay, stadium. Another one is what? Instar. Everything you have to understand. Okay. So what is instar? This is first instar. This is second. This is third. This is fourth. And this is fifth. So how can you define one instar? These states present in between egg states. Okay. And first molting, these are what? Moltings. This all arrow marker what? Moltings. Okay, these are moltings. The stage present in between egg stage and first molting. And in between subsequent moltings are called as what? Instar. Understood or not? You see, the stage present in between egg stage and first molting. This is not the molting. This one is what? Metamorphosis. The stage has been changed. Egg stage to larva stage. The body form has been changed. Egg to larva means what? Metamorphosis. This egg stage and first molting. Then in between subsequent moltings. The stages are called as what? Instar. Understood? So what is stadium? Stadium is what? The time interval. Okay. In between these two moltings, in between these two moltings, in between these two moltings, and in between these two moltings. The time interval between two subsequent molting is what? Stadium. Understood the difference? Okay. Metamorphosis is what? Metamorphosis means what? Totally the stage is different. Egg to larva, larva to pupa, pupa to adult. This process is what? Metamorphosis. Okay. Then come to instar. What is instar? It is the physical form of the states. In between what? Egg to post molding plus subsequent or consecutive moldings. Okay, this is the stage. Then come to stadium. What is stadium? Only time interval in between two subsequent or consecutive moldings. Understood? So these things you have to understand. So after understanding this instar and stadium in graphical way, now coming to this totally pictorial view, color photo. So what is instar? You see here, what is the instar is, this is the stage, okay? Stage between consecutive molding and in between egg and first molding. That means this one is a instar, 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 and this one is a instar. How to define this one? These stages present in between two consecutive moldings. In between these two moldings, this stage is present. In between these two, this stage is present. In between these two, this stage, like that. Okay. The stage present in between consecutive moldings plus, what is that? In between egg and first molding. This is the egg phase and in between the first molding. This stage. It is also called what? Instar. Understood? Yes or no? So here two things are there to be remembered. First one is what? In between egg and first molding. This stage plus in each consecutive molding. These stages are called as what? Instars. Understood? Now coming to the stadium. Stadium. First thing is, this is not the stage. This is the time interval, the time taken. For what? Or the time taken between two subsequent moldings. Starting from this, not this one. Okay, starting from this. How much time taken by the first instar larva to mold to become second instar larva? The time interval is what? Stadium. Then time taken in second molding. This also one stadium. In third molding, this one also stadium. Fourth molding, this one also stadium. Okay. Only between subsequent molding. Okay. Not like instar. Here, this phase. This phase is not a stadium. This phase is not a stadium. They are what? These are what? Metamorphosis. The egg has undergone metamorphosis to become larva. The fifth instar larva has undergone metamorphosis to become pupa. So these two are what? Metamorphosis. Like this you have to understand what is the difference. In instar, both egg to larva, egg to first molting and subsequent moldings. In stadium, only subsequent moldings. That is the thing I want to tell you. You have to write down correctly. Okay. So now try to see the definition. The interval between two subsequent molting is known as what? Stadium. And the body form or the stage between egg stage and first molting and two subsequent molting is called as what? Instar. Okay, this one is important. One more term is what? Tenera. Is the newly emerged pairs of budded individuals prior to completion of melanization and sclerotization. Okay. So what is tenera? Actually, what happens in this molting? Again, they are divided into some steps. Like first is apolysis, then egg dysis will occur, then sclerotization and melanization will occur. Okay, so this you see newly emerged pale soft body. Okay, newly emerged pale soft bodied individuals prior to completion of melanization and sclerotization. So while undergoing the insect will undergo apolysis, then egg dysis, then sclerotization. So up to this, the pale color soft body, that means their body can won't be hard at that time, their integument won't be hard. Okay, up to this phase the insect is called as what? Tenera. Understood? Okay, so like this you have to understand. Then come to this molting process is a complex process which involves three steps. Okay, what are those? Apolysis, egg dysis and sclerotization. So I will divide this video into four parts. First is this one we are covering now, second of apolysis, third of egg dysis, and fourth of sclerotization and melanization. So like this I will complete the video. Okay, for your easy understanding, and the video should not be lengthy. This apolysis again divided. Okay, apolysis itself. Okay, then come to this deposition of epicuticle. Epicuticle. Okay, then deposition of new procuticle. Okay, these two are where new one will be for. Okay, new one will be for. Like this again it is divided. It is divided. How it is divided, all those things I will tell you. So in the next video we will start apolysis or apolysis, whatever you are pronouncing. So I hope you understood this video. And if any kind of doubt is there, then kindly ask. Thank you for watching. Have a nice day.
Kiss me, close your eyes, miss me. Close your eyes and kiss me. I can read your lips on your fingertips. Me.